Hi, my name is Dr. Padilla. I'm a professor in computer science and psychology. I've been a professor for over 5 years now. Today, I wanted to talk about a topic that I've been avoiding to some degree on this channel, in part because I try to bring you lots of positivity. I know an academic journey can be quite long, so I want to give you inspiration to try to stay in there. So I've been avoiding this topic, and is applying to a PhD in 2025 worth it? With everything going on in the world, there's lots of uncertainty in regards to academia. And you might have heard some things on the news, so you might be wondering, should I apply? Shouldn't I? What are the pros and cons? So I wanted to have a real conversation about what I think you should consider when thinking about applying to a PhD in 2025. So let's jump on in. Okay, so let's talk about the elephant in the room. There have been some major changes going on in academia in the past year. I think the one that will affect you the most if you're considering applying for a PhD is funding. What has happened is major grants in the United States have been canceled from the major funders, including NIH and NSF. I have seen several of my colleagues get their grants defunded, and we don't really know what's gonna happen in terms of grant funding. The way that people often pay for PhD student salaries is with grant funding, okay? So there's just going to be less money to fund PhD students. The other element of this is that there's going to be lower enrollment, particularly for international students at every major institution in the United States. Now, that is going to hit hardest places that rely heavily on tuition to fund various programs. And those are particularly tuition for master's degrees for international students, because those are so expensive. There's some universities that really have major thriving master's degrees. So they are going to be hit pretty hard by the lack of enrollment from individuals outside of the US. Now, what that actually means for PhD admissions is there are fewer spots. There is less money coming from grants. And what particular departments are doing is cutting back funding for PhD students. Not all money comes from grants. Students can often be a TA or a teaching assistant to cover their stipend. And there's so many classes that we teach, we need many, many TAs. So it's not as if all these positions are going away. There's still gonna be the same amount of TA positions as there was before. But what is happening is these different departments are prioritizing their current PhD students. And they're saying, we need to ensure that these individuals are funded for the duration of their PhD. If that means that they all have to be funded on TAs, we need to make sure that we can accommodate that. They had originally thought that at least some of the proportion of those students would be covered on grants, which can be going away to some degree. So moving on to 2025-2026 cycle is they're going to have fewer spots in every department all across the United States. I don't think any department is immune from this. I think you might be seeing anywhere from half the spots in previous years to even less than that. So you can just expect the application process to be much more competitive. But I think that's the primary change that you will see, is that there's just gonna be fewer spots. That means that you need to have the best possible application if you want to get one of those spots. And they're certainly gonna go to someone, right? The spots aren't going away entirely, so it might as well be you. I have several videos about how to ensure that you're a really strong applicant, and this is definitely the time to do that. So I wouldn't say don't apply, but just recognize that you're gonna have to be very, very competitive to get those spots. So another thing you might be worried about in terms of funding is, say you get in, will your funding go away? It will not. What happens is when you accept a PhD offer, there's a contract that you sign and will have a guaranteed number of years that you're funded. You're guaranteed for that regardless of what happens to the university. That is in a contract. And if they don't fund you, they're violating their contract. So if you apply to a lab that is funded primarily on a grant, and that grant goes away, they will find money for you somewhere else. They have to by law. So don't worry about your funding disappearing. That's not gonna be the case. It's just gonna be harder to get to those spots initially. Another thing you might be asking is the experience in graduate school going to change? I don't really think it is. You know, we're not changing the courses we're offering. The programs are gonna be the same. The research is gonna be the same. So once you get in, I think the experience will be about the same as in previous years. The only caveat to that will be conference travel. If you have any restrictions on your travel for various visa situations, that will be harder for you to get around moving forward, possibly. So oftentimes we go to conferences all around the world to share our scholarly knowledge. So that type of travel could be trickier for you depending on your particular situation. The other thing you're really gonna wanna consider is after the PhD, after you go through the process and the experience, what then? Okay. So we are in a situation where faculty hiring has been severely limited, and that's going to go on for some time. But if you're applying for a PhD in 2025/2026, you are graduating in 2030. Who knows what's going to be going on at that time? I really don't think that you can make predictions about the faculty job market today that will be happening in 5 or 6 years from now. So I don't think you should necessarily consider that. I think this is definitely affecting people who are graduating in the next few years. It's going to be pretty challenging for them to find faculty positions. Also, normally, if faculty positions aren't available, you often do a postdoc for a few years. There's less funding for postdocs. So those are the individuals who are going to be more affected by this, the individuals graduating in the next few years. You applying to PhD programs now will be largely unaffected, unless, but other things can certainly happen by 2030 that, you know, who knows? The world changes very rapidly. So with all of that said, is it worth it to apply to a PhD program in 2025? I think yes. Like I said, someone's got to get those spots, right? Why not you? I think it's just going to be harder to get the spots. So you need to really lean in, put all of your effort into it, do all of the things I've told you in these videos, go over and beyond, meet the advisor, do the excellent work, put your best foot forward. You can get one of those spots and secure your future. But with that said, there's a lot of uncertainty going on in the world generally. So you do have to weigh the situations of your life, how much uncertainty you can take on. It's a 5-6 year commitment. Are you willing to, you know, have a lower salary for that time? Those are all personal decisions. But if you had been planning to apply to a PhD and you're just wondering, should you still do it? I think that if you can get in, it's still good, but it's gonna be trickier to get in. I hope that was useful. There's a lot of changes going on in academia now. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. I might consider doing a kind of monthly news recap if this is interesting to you. So please let me know in the feedback if it is. Thank you so much for watching and take care.